Good morning. What day is it? I mean, when it's a holiday week, we don't even know what day it is. It's Wednesday. I know I'm running late. I don't know why I was running late yesterday. I was running late today. I don't have my ice out. I don't have my water. Lady is right here wanting to get fed like right now. As you know, that if we don't feed Lady right away when she wakes up, she very well may perish from malnutrition, as we know. So I'm gonna feed her. I've got some music playing this morning, so listen to that for a second. I'm gonna feed Lady, and then we have something really fun to talk about today. Some questions to ask. All right, give me a minute. Alexa, volume up. Okay, friends, Lady is now eating. You can eat, go ahead. She also has to wait for me to tell her to eat. I don't know why, it's so strange. Lady will now not die of malnutrition, so we can all go about. Can you hear what song is playing? Of course it's Happily Ever After by Jordan Fisher. So listen, yesterday was Josie, our middle daughter, yesterday was Josie Voris's first day at her new job at Disney Plus. So yesterday was her first day at her, we call it her big girl job. So that's what we've been saying since she got offered this job, and she's been in California now 2 weeks. And yesterday was her first week, it's her big girl job. And she was on the Walt Disney Studio lot. What? She was on the Walt Disney Studio lot and doing all her, you know, like new employee onboarding and all this kind of stuff. And to kick off the training, they played a video, you know, what it's like to work for Disney, why people love Disney, all, you know, all of that. And she said, she's like, Mom, you would have cried. Because the end of the video was this. Was this song with this whole compilation of why people love working at Disney, and she's like, Mom, you would have cried. I'm like, I would have bawled. And she said, that's why you're not working for them. because no, but anyway, there's a whole video about why it's awesome to work for Disney and welcome to Disney and onboarding and all that kind of stuff. And they ended with this song at the end of the video. Because of course they did, because it's the best song there is. Bring back Jordan Fisher. Bring back Happily Ever After. Okay, that's crazy. And today she continues her onboarding. And she was in a building yesterday that was like Disney streaming. It's on the campus, on the lot of the Walt Disney Studios. So she was in the Disney streaming building yesterday. But today she goes back from her onboarding, and today she has an advanced screening of the new movie, Thor. Just a casual Wednesday at work for Josie Voris. She'll be seeing an advanced screening of the movie, Thor, in a studio, in a theater on the studio lot. I mean, she has the coolest job ever. It's the coolest job ever. Okay. Let's see what I've got here. Oh, do I want this one? Okay, I'll use this one. because I'm talking about the compass. I'm talking about the compass planner today. I see there are some questions. Also, I feel like there were some questions that were completely off topic that came in. Does no one else think that my daughter's job is cool besides me? I'm sorry. If we don't acknowledge the fact that she's seeing an advanced screening of Thor and she's working on the Walt Disney Studio lot, then I need you all to just leave Energize Live right now. Just go. Go. Understand how cool it is and then come back and try again, okay? All right, let's get this energized going, shall we? Thank you, Heather. Thank you. Thank you for, yes, just leave. Like, if you don't think it's cool that you're work that she's working for Disney, get out. Get out. She has a business degree. She has a business degree. She ended up graduating from Butler. Her job is called Content Strategy Analyst. And she really has no idea. I mean, she does. She knows what that means. I think when she got to work yesterday and really started talking to her boss and her boss's boss and understanding like who else is kind of in that building and around that building that she'll be interacting with, she's like, oh, this is a big job. This is a big job. So I think she's a little also bit, like, wow, this is a big job. So, but you know what? Did you ever have that feeling? I asked her this. I said, are you excited to go back to work tomorrow? And she goes, I'm so excited to go back to work tomorrow. You know, she goes, I wish that these 2 weeks were over. Like, I wish I really knew what I was doing. I felt more comfortable. But I'm super excited to go back to work tomorrow. And I said, you know, when I taught high school English, I remember after the first day and walking out to my car and going, oh, crap, I have to come back and do this tomorrow. And I was not excited. There were bits and pieces of it that were exciting, but I was not excited. And I went to high school in a tiny little town where I grew up, and the teachers had all been there forever. And my first high school teaching job was at the high school that from which I graduated. And all those teachers had been there forever. I mean, career teachers. And I looked around thinking, I don't want to do this for the next 40 years. And as much as I enjoy bits and pieces of teaching, I very clearly remember walking out of there that day and going, I have to come back here and do this again tomorrow. And everyone around me has been doing this for their entire lives. And I don't think I want to do that. And that was kind of a pivot moment for me, even at 22, you know, it was a pivotal moment for me to know that there's probably going to be another path for me. Certainly, I did not grow up saying, I would like to build a online fitness business. I would like to coach and mentor women using health and wellness as the vehicle to do that. No one grows up doing that. But I am so thrilled for her that she is excited to go back tomorrow. Of course, not every day will be I'm excited to go back to work. But on the first day, when I left my classroom and I thought, oh crap, I have to do this again tomorrow. And all the people around me have been doing it for all their lives. I thought, there's something off here. This is not my space. And that was my clue that this was not where I was gonna be forever. Now, here's the thing. A lot of people will feel that, and I don't say this like I'm so awesome, like you already know that I don't feel that way. I say this because a lot of people will feel that, but for whatever reason, humans won't do anything about it. You know, I've shared the comment that my husband's good friend made to him when he decided that he was done coaching football, at least at Butler University, when he was done and retired last fall after the last game. His husband, my husband's best friend, all through high school, college, whatever, said, "Oh, I knew you were unhappy, but I didn't think you would do anything about it." And I thought, my gosh, how many people does that describe in this on this planet of 7 billion people? How many humans are unhappy and don't do anything about that? And we kind of touched on this yesterday, just in all the things. Like, that's implied consent that being average and unhappy is okay. And I didn't know what I was going to end up doing, but I knew after that first day that being a career high school English teacher was not in the cards for me. And that's why I'm so excited that Josie loves, I mean, she's excited and energized by what she gets to do. And again, not every day will feel like that. A lot of days will be really hard work. And at the same time, she's excited about it. And she feels like she's right where she's supposed to be. And I don't want any of my children, I don't want any of you, I don't want any female on this planet to be like, "Ugh, well, I'm unhappy, but I'm not going to do anything about it." That's implied consent that it's okay to be unhappy. And we are not about that. We are absolutely not about that. We are not about that. Hi, Sandra. Sandra, how are you? Oh, I love reconnect. This is why I love social media, you know, because you get to reconnect and connect with people that you've known forever. So, Gina, no, not that I'm aware of. They have not hired a bunch of people. She had to go through a lot of auditions. So, yeah, it's really cool. Okay, we're going to go outside. I finished a book yesterday called Insight. I shared it with you last week. And I want to share with you some questions that were posed in the book, and I want you to do some thinking. Do you feel like thinking this morning? I'm feeling like the energy is a little, like we're not really sure what our energy is today. I understand that. Let me ask you this. Now listen. You already know, we've had this discussion before, that spiritually, all the things, you know, you're a 10. You're a 10 because you woke up on this side of the planet today, right? Okay. But tell me really, how's your energy? Tell me really. Are you good? How are you feeling really? Because we're about to get into it. Okay, we're ready. Okay, we're ready. Okay, here we go. I got to try to remember them because I didn't write them down, but I thought to myself yesterday, okay, we've got to talk about these today. Start, stop. I'm going to ask you two of the three. Okay, I'm going to ask you two of the three questions. We'll see if I remember the third when we get into it. I should have brought out the book. Okay, here we go. Talking about habits. Number one, and I want you to think on this, jot it down if you want, but I want you to put some stuff in the comments, okay? Number one, what habits do you need to start or restart doing to move you closer to your goals, to make you feel better? And remember, we talked about how yesterday was really the first day of July, and we are on a mission now to get in the best shape of our life, physically and mentally, like the best shape of our lives. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to stay accountable to you. I'm going to tell you what I did in service of that goal in just a moment. So question number one is, in service of your big goals, what is something you need to start or restart doing? Effective immediately. Power hours. So this is so outstanding, it's ridiculous. Plan my nutrition. Full power hours. I'm doing my favorite parts. Block scheduling my day.
intentional business time. I need to be better at choosing what deserves my energy. That's a mindset, not a habit, Sheena. So I want you to actually dig in for a tangible, actionable item. Waking up earlier. Lori Ummer, what do you mean by waking up earlier? Earlier could be like 1 minute. Like instead of 6, I'm going to get up at 5:59. What do you mean? What is a specific habit that you need to start or restart doing? Hydrate. Emily, what does that mean? Going to bed on time. Jessica, what does that mean? Restart my workouts. What is nutrition? What does that mean, Isabel? What does that even mean? Office hours and out of my home. Office hours are hard in the summer. Yeah. Scheduling my day. Okay. So are you writing these down? Make sure you just take a moment and like in your compass planner, I do a lot of, listen, I got you on the next version because I've got some blank pages. I've got some blank pages for you so you can write some things down. But you know, somewhere where you can find some blank space, go in your compass planner and just write down maybe start and jot that down so that you know what you, Lori, you're getting up at 7 and you want to give a 5:30. Okay. Yeah. Journaling your food. Amelia, do you find that helpful? Do you use the To Be Mindset journal? Journaling food. So Beth, I see what you're saying there. I understand where you're going with that. I think you're going to need to put some more specificity to that. Okay, so we got the idea. Something that we need to start doing. Here's the thing we always already know, right? Always already know. So let's write it down. Write it down in your compass planner. The habit that you are starting or restarting in service of your bigger goals, in service of your bigger goal, starting or restarting, put it in your compass planner somewhere. Like here's some, don't worry, I got you on the second round later this year. You're gonna have some blank pages, but just put it in here for now. Okay. Question two. Ready? Question two. What do you need to stop doing in service of your goals? I'm going to walk and find the book while you're thinking and writing. What habits have you picked up? Have you gone back to whatever that you need to stop doing in service of your goals? Where is my book? Here it is. I'll show you what I'm thinking of reading next. I think I might read that one next. I finished this book today, or yesterday. I said this one, so I got two then. Okay. What habits do you need to stop doing? Something that you've picked up that she's so cute, I can't stand it. I'm coming back out, lady. I'm coming back out. Sorry, this is a really awkward angle. Okay. Let me go back up here. Ba 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 ba. So I really, can we please think in terms of rather than, gosh, now I gotta look through this book and find it. Rather than mindset, can we please think in terms of habits and get a little bit more concrete? So Diane, I appreciate your share. It's a little ambiguous. So here we go. Start model. Okay, here, I got it. Yeah. So what do you need to stop doing that isn't serving you well? What do you, and I really want you just to think in terms of this exercise, just this morning, a little bit more habits rather than mindset. Absolutely have the mindsets, but just for us, for right now, just, you know, habits. Gina, I'll address that because you're very vulnerable in sharing that, and I appreciate that. Drinking too much and scrolling social media and dating apps. Thank God I'm not doing that. I mean, bless your heart. Thank God I don't have to do that anymore. I never did that. Dating apps weren't even a thing when I got married. My husband and I have been married since we were born. So thank God I didn't have to do that. I'm just going to throw this out there. This is probably an unpopular, controversial opinion. I'm just going to throw it out there only because you brought it up, Gina, and everyone can do with it what they want. There's really no benefit to alcohol. I said what I said. There's really no benefit to it. And there are so many pluses when you don't have it in your life. And newsflash, it's really not that big of a deal when you don't drink. I don't drink. I really never have. The occasional mountain wine berry cooler or something in college, the occasional something or other cooler or something when my husband and I were dating. I don't really like alcohol, so I'm like, this feels pointless. But Jesse's 21, so probably I haven't had a drink in 21 years at least. Gina, I'm only sharing that since you threw it out there. I promise you, if you just stop, everything in your life gets better, and it's really not that big of a deal. I'm just going to throw that out there. Do with it what you will. Oh, a lot of scrolling. Lori, you know, I feel you on that, and I think you've got, you know, some special circumstances in your family that probably lend itself to that, so I'm glad that you see that. That's great self-awareness, putting the family and their needs ahead of your own every day. So a lot of scrolling. Wow. Going to bed so late. Getting into your cravings at night because they wreck your energy in the morning. Heather, I'm going to encourage you to actually start tracking your food. Maybe that's a start, because I'm wondering if you're just not feeding yourself what you need during the day, you know? And so you get these cravings at night. Also, a few nights a week, not every night of the week, but a few nights a week, I like a little 8 or 9 p.m. little salty snack. I grew up with my dad doing that. You know, he'd have like a jar of peanuts or he'd have some pretzels. And so I saw him doing that and I kind of grew up with that. And I heard some really good advice from a nutritionist one day that said, well, since you know you want to do that, why don't you just build that into your daily nutrition rather than getting mad at yourself for doing it? And I'm like, oh, wow, what a concept. Plan for it. Ha ha. What a concept. Lot of scrolling. Why are we, what? Patty, why are you up till 11:30? Who can even stay awake till 11:30? I was on the phone with Josie last time because, you know, she's 3 hours behind and she called and it was 10:24 when we got off phone. I'm like, what the actual F is happening? I'm up way too late. Lot of scrolling. Well, Gina, I'm going to ask you this question. Because you say it's tough because you do enjoy it. Do you enjoy the taste? You do enjoy the taste, which is fine. Of course, you can enjoy the taste of a margarita. But there's clearly something about it in there that is not serving you. So it's something to think about. If you enjoy the taste, it's 2022. There's a lot of really amazing mocktails in this world. Listen, I am a Shirley Temple connoisseur. You want to know where the best Shirley Temples are? I got you. I've got a lot of scrolling here to do. Yeah. Okay. Yes, Emily, that's awesome. Okay, so we're caught up. So we did, what should you start doing that you're not? What should you stop doing that isn't serving you? Okay, so we've had those two, and I hope you've written them down too. What'd you start doing? What do you need to start doing? What do you need to stop doing? Now, here's one I really want to dig into because we forget to actually look at this part too. Ready? Oh, my light went off. That's okay. Here we go. Oh, Gina, you got to dig into that, my friend. That is a conversation that is deeper than Energized Eye, but you got to dig into that because there's something behind that. Okay, what should you start doing that you're not doing? What should you stop doing that isn't serving you well? And here we go, number three. What should you continue doing to be successful? So chances are there's something in your life that you're doing that's working. What should you continue doing to be successful? It's not like your entire life needs to be overhauled, right? We got to give ourselves some credit for what we're doing that actually is working. So what should you start doing? What should you stop doing? But what do you need to continue doing? What's working for you? Okay, let's go in the comments. What's working for you right now that you want to make sure you continue doing? And don't tell me nothing. That's not true. What is working for you that you want to continue doing? And I'm going to put this book in the comments really quick. Tasha Urich. Okay, that's the book that I'm quoting from, and I highly, highly recommend getting it. Okay, let's see what we're doing that's working. Personal development podcasts. Oh, it says that I waved at someone. I don't even know what that means. Morning routines working well. Good. That's awesome. Working out every day is working. That's awesome. Workouts, PD, Energized Life. Focused work blocks. The Pomodoro method. I love that. There's a planner out there for that too. My morning routine. My daily devotional, personal, perfect morning routine. The Compass Planner. I know. I got two messages yesterday. Listen, y'all, I got two messages yesterday. Really incredible messages from women who were like, I've paid off all my bills because I've been using the Compass Planner. And another one was, she's starting something. She's doing, I can't remember what it was. I screenshotted it because it was so good. And she's doing something. I'm like, because once you understand what you do every single day and how it relates to your big dream goals, we take the drama out of it. So good. So this is so good. What do you want to continue doing? Meal prepping, showing up, eating more veggies, solid morning routine, working out first thing in the morning. I love that. Continuously learning, morning routine. So the morning routine's working. I love it. Yeah, huddles. Heather, I can't even tell you. Is Chris Branch on here? Sometimes she's on. She just finished Huddle too. She's like, this is the best book ever. It's so good. It's ridiculous. Keeping a morning routine, meal prepping. So look at what you're doing that's working. Look what you're doing that's working. There's so much that you're doing that's working. We tend to focus on the stuff that we think we have to stop. We're so bad. I'm so mad at myself. But look what you're doing that's working. So let's really focus on this. Daily walks. I know. Walks keep me sane. Walking at night after dinner, that's amazing. Morning routine. So we've got a lot of good stuff. And when you really dig into that and you see it very visually, well, now you have a choice, right? Now you have a choice because there are pieces of your life that are working really, really well. They're serving your goals. Serving your goals, serving your vision, serving your dreams, serving your goals, serving the way you want to feel, serving the way you want to live your life. Okay, we want to keep doing that. But you already know that there's places where you need to kind of strip away some of the junk and the fluff. But you, since you know that, now you have the opportunity to do it. Now you have the opportunity to do it. Who is the author of Huddle? Megan. Her name is Brooke. Brooke. Baldwin? Is that right? Brooke Baldwin, maybe? Brooke something. I want to say Baldwin, but I don't know that that's correct. something like that. If you type in Huddle and Brooke into Google, it'll come up. It'll come up. It's so good. Okay, so that's what I wanted to bring to you today, along just with this book, and it's just really, really good. I finished it yesterday. I'd set the goal to finish it before Summit, and I finished it in like 3 days. And it's all about, it's about awareness. It's about self-awareness. I underlined so many pieces of this book. And this is another piece that I want to share with you, and then we're going to wrap up. That I thought was so good. Okay. So let's say something in your life is a challenge for you. Something in your life is a challenge for you. You've got a business goal that you're challenged with. You've got a family goal that you're challenged with, etc. The common mindset is that we start asking why. Why is this happening to me? Why can't I figure this out? Why? The lesson here is asking what keeps us open to discovering new information about ourselves. Asking why has the opposite effect. If you ask why, you're putting yourself into a victim mentality. When I feel anything other than peace, I say, what's going on? What am I feeling? What is the dialogue inside my head? What's another way to see this situation? What can I do to respond better? Ask what, not why. Why questions draw us to our limitations. What questions help us see our potential? Why questions stir up negative emotions? What questions keep us curious? Why questions trap us in our past? What questions help us create a better future? Making the transition from why to what can be the difference between victimhood and growth. If you take nothing else from this week, there's your piece right there. So you've got these pieces in your life that you want to continue. And then you've got these pieces over here you want to start, and these pieces over here you want to stop. So instead of saying to yourself, why can't I just stay on track? Could you start saying, what about my schedule is making me do this? Or what about this feeling do I want to change? Or what can I do to feel more on top of my nutrition? Or what can I do to feel like I have more time in the morning? Instead of asking why, because why becomes character judgment, why becomes emotion, why becomes drama? Lord knows we have enough of that. Can we switch that to what and start making it about action? So good. So good. So good. So good. So take this little exercise that we did today with what you want to continue doing, what you want to start doing, what you want to stop doing. And instead of asking the why behind, why can't I stop snacking at night? Start asking yourself what in terms of those little buckets, and see what actions and habits you can come out of it with. And I hope this was helpful. I hope this was helpful. Okay. So if you have a compass planner, or if, yes, exactly, Chris, bring less shame. There's, and it, Lord knows, you know, I'm talking to mostly women. Women don't need to create, manufacture, or incur any more shame, guilt, any, stop. Just stop with the nonsense. So if you have a compass planner, or you buy one before noon today, you can join us for our noon Eastern Standard Time Zoom. And we're just going to really make it open to any of your questions. You know, what's challenging you? Where do you find some roadblocks? How can I help? How can we kind of heartstorm together and find some ways to help you have really good habits so that you stay on track? And that's happening at noon Eastern Standard Time. I issued a challenge last week, I think, 12,000 steps a day. That's not necessary. 12K a day. Let me know in the comments how many of you are in for that and are hitting 12K a day. 12K a day. That's our goal, 12K a day. A couple people tagged me yesterday. I'm so excited to see people doing that, 12K a day. 12K a day. So that's what we're trying to do. 12K a day. And... wow. I've got two books I'm looking at that I'm not sure which I'm going to. This is one, How Women Rise, and I opened up this chapter and it said one of the habits that women have is reluctance to claim your achievements. I'm always like, expecting others to notice and reward. Oh, Lord. I probably need to read the book. 12K day. So compass planner call today at noon, 12K a day. And then yesterday I issued a big challenge. And that is, no, breathe does not count towards steps. Nice try. I rode the bike yesterday too. Still got my 12,000. I think I was at, I don't know what I was at yesterday. I might have hit 20, but I'm not sure. Might not have been quite that high. And then last, I'm really issuing a challenge to you. I'm going to issue it to my team. I think in this world that feels like there's so much chaos and so much fog, and we can't even figure out what we want to eat for dinner, and we wake up and we wonder if the small habits that we have can make a difference. I am here to tell you that yes, your small habits will make a difference. Your small habits are your anchor and your grounding. Your small habits will keep you centered. And I believe to my core, I'll fight anyone who tells me this, that the stronger you get physically, the stronger you get mentally. When you go all in on your health and fitness journey, it crowds out space in your brain to be thinking about high school drama, to be thinking about how we don't even know what's happening tomorrow, character judgment, limiting beliefs. When you go all in on your health and fitness journey and you get up and you've got a solid morning routine, you know that's my vision. All over the world, women are going to get up. They're going to tap into Energize Live. They're going to make their Energize. They're going to get out their compass planner. They're going to write down their goals and dreams. They're going to move their body with intention, not half-ass move their body, not pick up a 3-pound weight when they can pick up a 5, not pick up a 10 when they can pick up a 15, but like get in your journey and go all in. And you're going to look at your nutrition and you're going to make good choices that fuel you and help you feel your best. I don't give two poops about calories. That fuel you and help you feel your best, because you already know what you need to do. When you go all in with that and you say, I am going to be in the best shape of my life by December 31st, I promise you, watch what other good stuff happens when you make that commitment. Watch how little time you have to worry about what people are thinking, saying, doing, drama, other bullshit. Watch how little time you have to worry about that. And watch how your life changes when you go all in with your journey. Because what you do in your workouts is what you do in your life, 100%. What you do in your workouts is what you do in your life. And that's my challenge to you. Get your 12K a day in as part of this journey towards getting in the best shape of your life. And I don't care about your physical results. I care about your mental, your spiritual, your emotional, financial, all the other O's, all that transformation, that's what I care about. And I know that if you will go all in with your health and fitness journey, your life will change. I know that because I've lived it and I've seen it and I've watched it and I've been a part of it. And we're all looking for ways to decrease decision fatigue and to increase peace and positivity and confidence. I believe it's through your health and wellness journey. I believe that it is. So if you're in for that, I would love to know, because I'm excited. I to stay accountable, I will tell you, yesterday we kind of talked about this and I issued this challenge. And I don't know why I haven't done this before, but I think Josie might have taken my 20-pound weights, but I knew I needed to order more dumbbells for the weight rack, and I just hadn't done it, and I'd just been kind of dorking around with my 17 and a halfs, knowing I needed 20s. Yesterday, I'm like, no, order the 20-pound weights. Order the weight bench. Order the things that you need so that you're not just kind of sort of doing the program. Let's freaking go. Can I get more than 12K a day? Can I dial in my nutrition a little more? Can I level up my hydration a little bit more? Can I protect my peace a little bit more? What can I do to get in the best shape of my life by December 31st? That's what I'm doing. I hope you're into. All right. If you are part of this, I'll see you at noon today. Otherwise, I'll see you on stories, and I'll see you tomorrow morning. Go make it a great day. There's your sunrise, my friends. Oh my gosh, it's so good every day. So good every day. Go make it a great day.